So the other day, we were told about having a new event, right? And how we were getting one new operator, Scotty. But then it was told that we're also getting another operator, a 5-star, Granny. Okay, and so that was already dope enough. But actually, we are not just getting 2 characters. We're not even getting 3. We're not even getting 4. We're actually getting 5 new characters. And I don't understand why I am just now finding out about this and why more people are not talking about this. Holy shit! This event is a hell of a lot bigger than you probably think. And we're going to talk about all the shit that you need to do to prepare for all that shit, everything that you're going to get. I will keep this video spoiler-free of any of the maps and the difficulty and, you know, what the mechanics would be, but I will suggest certain units or a certain unit type in order to help you combat that, and also a certain level that you should get to in order to get the full rewards this entire event, which, by the way, the entire event is actually completable as a free-to-play player, and there is a lot of shit. I'd assume that you'd have to pick and choose what you're going to get, but no. Arknights is being incredibly generous. This event is going to be absolutely insane. But first off, I want to talk about the 5 units. Just a quick little sneak peek at all the new units that are coming out for this event. Okay, going to have to re-record this part because I got a little bit too excited. Let's try to calm down this time, Tecton. Okay, so we're getting 5 new units, right? The first one that we're going to get is Scotty. Now, Scotty has the ability. Once again, we're just talking about sneak peeks, and then I'll do a full in-depth guide on each one of these units before the event comes out. Don't worry, in case you want to know who to aim for and who you really want to get as soon as possible. So, Scotty. She's pretty much your standard melee guard, and she has the ability to have like a steroid type effect where she gets super jacked for a short period of time, but it's a very long cooldown, but she becomes a god temporarily, which is super dope. The next unit that we're going to be getting is one of the, this is a lot of people's, gotta calm down. There's a lot of people's favorite waifu. Her name is Nightmare. She's dope as shit. She fills a very niche role, which is she has 2 types of roles that she can fill. She can be a damage dealing healer, which means the more damage she does, the more she heals her surrounding allies. And then she also has a AoE surrounding slow. And then the further that these units move, the more damage they take, and they take like a cursive effect. Now, that a lot of people hear that and they hear, well, if they move or if they take more damage the further they move, why does she slow them? It is counter synergy. However, you can pair her up with certain units to bypass that and make some really crazy shit. So I will be making a combo synergy guide on that video as well. We're also getting Granny, who is probably the unit that I'm looking forward to getting most from this entire event. She is the same type of Vanguard as Vigna, so every single time she gets a kill, you will get more SP. And she has a lot of Vanguard synergy, and she has an amazing skill too, which is, you know, reduce attack range, becomes a defender type attack range, attack and defense plus 30%, block count plus 1, but she will attack every unit that she blocks, which is insane, which effectively doubles her DPS in a lot of situations, which is insane. But once again, 5-star Vanguard for free. That's really damn nice. That's really damn nice and super easy to get. Now, there's also Bee Hunter, which I'm excited to get her too, but that's because I'm a huge JoJo's Bizarre Adventure fan, and this character is literally Star Platinum. She's really cool. Just to give you an idea of what she's about, okay? Just to give you a quick little idea, the more she attacks something, the stronger she gets, okay? But you got to stack it up, so you got to attack a lot. Now, that would be a problem for a lot of people. However, her base attack speed is 0.78. That's really, really, really fast. It's the same speed as Indra, which is, I believe, is the fastest attack speed in the game. However, when you max up her skill 2, she can reduce her attack interval by 0.6 seconds, so then she will attack 5 times every second. This unit will attack, you heard me right, 5 times every second. And that is so fucking cool. I cannot wait to use her. And the last up, we're getting a 3-star Midnight. Now, a lot of people might see this unit and think that he's dog shit. I assure you, he's not. He's kind of like a, He's kind of like an Indra type. But 3-star. But his attack range is absolutely insane. So let's talk about that real quick. His attack range is the same as Silver Ashes on E1, which, that's crazy. That is crazy range. That's going to make him pair up with a Vanguard right in front of him very well, because then they can block with the Vanguard. He can stay behind them and beat them the entire time. And also, he is a counter armor unit, because whenever you pop his ability, his attack, his physical damage actually turns to magical damage. So that will bypass all armor. However, the charge time is really fucking long. But regardless, man, great unit. Great, great, great unit. This is going to change free players' life drastically. So now let's talk the rewards that you can get for this event and why you're going to be grinding. First of all, the amount of grinding that you can do in order to get the tier 3 rewards and just E2 mats in general, and just mats in general, is about 50% what you would get otherwise farming the regular stages right now. So you need to be farming your ass off the entire duration of this event. Now, if you are free to play with no refreshes, you can legit get every reward here right now. This is not capped to just pay-to-win players. It does get a little bit dicey when you take into consideration that you having to do your Annihilation 2 and cap that shit out for a random. But if you do complete all of the grinding that is necessary, you keep your sanity not capped off, you always have it running, you will be able to get all the rewards that are displayed right here, as long as you play efficiently and you don't let that sanity overcap. And by the way, you can sleep a pretty decent night's rest and not let your sanity cap, which, you know, hey, I'm not saying you should do that, but I'm letting you know that is what I do. But I'm an absolute loser. Moving on. Let's talk about this here, because this is actually very important. It is very important to notice, okay? Granny, you will be able to get 5 tokens on top of actually getting Granny, so you will be able to max the potential of your Granny. So we will be getting a max potential Granny from this event, which is absolutely insane, because that's going to reduce her DP cost even further, going to make her even better. Tons of tier 3 rewards, even tier 4 rewards. I mean, so much shit. Tickets, tons of summons. Well, not tons, but hey, summons nonetheless. Some more cosmetic, which is going to be great for the pizzeria, but just the match in general is going to save my ass. Because god damn, I need more mats, man. Farm out all the mats that you can. After Granny, the mat should be your priority. I'm going to farm cosmetics first because cosmetics are very important to me. But yeah, definitely, definitely try to make sure you get all of these items. This event is probably going to be 14 or 15 days. So farm your ass off. You will not regret it. You'll get so much shit. Your account will explode with progress. And from what I've been told, I watch a lot of Just3C. His guides are amazing. I definitely recommend his channel. And also, I've been asked to shout out another channel called Lanif. They played the Arknights game a long time ago on the CN server. I'll link their YouTube videos in my description, but they make some great Arknights stuff, and they provide a lot of useful info, so I do want to shout them out. If I haven't already, I'm not sure if I did, but they're great YouTube content creators, and there's a ton of other great Arknights creators, but I just want to shout them out real quick, just in case I didn't already. They have some good information out for the event as well. So yeah, just farm your ass off. Make sure you get these mats. It's going to be dope. And now let's talk about some units and level requirement that you should get in order to make your progress through this event even faster. Because while the event is extremely challenging, it can be a lot less taxing if you have a certain unit type that can perform a certain role. So the big gist for this event is there's going to be a lot of maps with a shit ton of units that come at the same time. So you're going to need an AoE damage dealer. Now, this is going to be a lot different than what we've been dealing for chapter 4 and below, because generally all the units are heavily armored. This is not the case. There will be some specific armored units, and I will recommend some units to run for that. But the big thing that you're going to want to run is an AoE sniper that does physical damage, okay? So units that I recommend for that is Meteorite. She's absolutely amazing. I'd probably run around skill 1. You don't need to shred through too much armor, so Fireball will be a little bit useless. And then we also have Shirayuki, which if you haven't got her, I highly recommend watching my recruitment guide video. I mean, once again, I know some people don't get Shirayuki, but if you know how to properly tag, by now you should already have a Shirayuki, and she will tear shit up, and her range is super fucking long, so positioning her properly will not be a challenge whatsoever, and she's just a great unit inside this event and out. And the last unit, which everybody should have if they've been playing since the beginning of Arknights, which has been about 2 weeks or so, is Catapult. The game legitimately gave us this unit. She's absolutely amazing. Her attack range is crazy long. And yeah, her damage is... It's great for an AoE sniper. And dude, she's adorable. All right, so yeah, AoE physical damage sniper is going to be great for you to use. Now, there also is some single target, really big, thick boys that you need to take care of with arts damage. Units that I recommend for that is Amiya. Everybody's going to have Amiya. Amiya will absolutely dumpster these units. If you E1 her, that's fine. Run around ability 1. If you E2 her, once again, you're probably going to want to run around ability 1 as well. You should just turret shred through all of them. You'll be good to go. Other units that I recommend, if you pull a Midnight from the event, you can use him. But if not, just, you know, just like your standard single target damage dealers that does arts damage. Nothing really too fussy. I mean, you can even use AoE splash damage if you like. But just make sure that you have at least one unit that does single target arts damage. So that way you can shred through those big boys. It doesn't matter who it is, but I know everybody has a man, so I might as well shout out a recommendation. And then Just3C recommended this. So I will say this, guys, I don't necessarily believe this. I don't really think that you need to. But if you want to build an AoE slow unit as well, or just a single target slow unit as well, you can. Yeah, so you can build like Orchid, you know, Angelina, all that shit. Once again, I don't think that it's necessary, but you can if you like. The most important thing, in my opinion, for this event is just a strong single target arch damage dealer and then a strong long distance AoE physical damage dealer. Last tip, I believe the event should be going live at February 5th, 6 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, okay? So if you want to get on for minute one, definitely be on right then. And if you want to drop by a Twitch stream and have any more questions that you have answered, you're more than welcome to drop by my Twitch anytime, twitch.tv/tactown, or also my Discord, discord.gg/tactown. This event is crazy generous, and there won't be another event exactly like this for a long time. The event that I mean like that. What I mean by an event like this is that this event gives you crazy free shit for E2ing units. So, dude, get in there, do the grinding, have your units at E1 level 10 is fine if you want to big brain it, like a full team of E1 level 10. But if you want to play it safe and really maximize your grinding, I personally would recommend having a full team of at least E1 level 30 to E1 level 40. Because, look, dude, I know. People can do it at E1 level 10, but sometimes, you know, people play that they're tired, they're busy at work, they can't think too much. So if you have other shit going on and you want to make sure that you can breeze through it, and that's some shit that people need to understand. I know it can be done at E1 level 10 if you play at peak performance, but people got shit going on, man, and they have other shit to do in their lives. So if you just want to like breeze through it, just make sure you have a team of at least E1 level 30 to E1 level 40, in my opinion, and maybe an E2 or two if you just want to shit on it. Okay, if you want to shit on it, have an E2 unit as well. But honestly, I think you'll be fine with E1 level 30, even more fine. You'll breeze through it if you have an entire team of E1 level 40. It's gonna be a great event. Your units are going to skyrocket from here, and that's very important. Because keep in mind, the event update after this is going to be Chapter 5. And you're going to need all the help you can get. Okay? You're going to need all the help that you can get. Because that chapter is going to be fucking crazy. I hope y'all are hyped for this event. I got so excited about it on stream today. I'm starting to lose my voice. Which is very scary. Because I don't want to lose my voice. But yeah, this event's going to be fucking nuts. yeah, definitely check out those content creators I recommended. Lots of good content creators on Twitch. Oh, shout outs to XLICE as well. That's twitch.tv/XLICE. Fucking amazing. Peace, Cal, Anavis. So many great people in the Arknights community. I definitely hope that you give them a chance. And yeah, the Arknights community is looking great. And it continues to get better every single day, especially with this new goddamn event. I cannot wait for Chapter 5. And I cannot wait to grind my ass with this event. Because when you see the aesthetic of the new map and when you see the aesthetic of the new levels, you are going to fucking nut. Oh my god, dude. It's so clean. It's my favorite aesthetic. I really can't wait to make videos for the new event. It looks so clean, but I don't want to give any spoilers. So stay tuned to this channel if you want to check all that shit out as it comes live. And I'll do a full unit review once again of all the units that are coming out before the event drops. So look forward to that. Anywho, hope you'll like, comment, and subscribe. If not, it's cool. I understand. And yeah, thanks for checking out my shit. Anywho, I've been Tecto and y'all been great. Hope you are having a damn good one. And as always, peace.